Hi, my name is Casey and I'm the director of GO61. Right now I'm standing in a motel in Springfield. It's about a central location, and this motel is commonly used. It's one of many in our town that's commonly used where girls are sold for commercial sex. And the past few weeks, every single week, we've had more than 145 girls and women sold for commercial sex in Southwest Missouri. This is in Springfield, Joplin, and Branson, with the majority of those numbers being in Springfield. We've seen numbers as high as 74, 79 ads a day for our commercial sex placed right here in Springfield just through one popular prostitution website. Did you know that the U.S. Department of State frequently says that any community that tolerates prostitution tolerates the exploitation of women and children, and a community that tolerates prostitution tolerates child trafficking and human trafficking. This is a situation that is growing in our city. We can no longer turn our backs on it. But we rented this room here tonight, and just outside, we had only been here 30 seconds, and the lady came up to us, said that a man is going door to door asking if there's heroin available. And this is a lady who is staying in a room next door to us. She has two teenagers staying with her, and that in itself is a little alarming of what they're doing in this type of situation. And the motel that we are in now, we recently helped a girl escape from the streets, and in this motel, she was drugged, she was raped, and she woke up the next morning with strangers in bed with her. She was beaten up, she was able to escape, and we were able to put her on a bus back home to reunite her with her parents. She had had a drug addiction problem, and in staying in this motel, she ran into traffickers and drug dealers, and that's how they came across her. So this is something that doesn't happen once a year or even once a month in our city, but it happens every single night where women and children are for sale. By our estimates and by statistic estimates of the U.S. State Department, 89 to 92% of people in prostitution are actually human trafficking victims. Just last week I talked to a federal agent and I asked him if he agreed with that statistic, if he thought that that was a realistic and accurate one, and he said he believed it was probably pretty close to being accurate. The prostitution, 89 to 92% of those who are in prostitution are actually human trafficking victims. So if we have on one day 75 prostitution ads, and 89% of those are human trafficking victims, and then half of human trafficking victims are minors with the average age of being 12 years old, unless we're unique from any other place in the country, from every other place in the country, we have a significant problem right here in Springfield, Missouri with human trafficking. In the past year and a half, we've talked to more than 800 girls who have been sold for commercial sex, girls and women. A lot of these are in prostitution now, and they have come from backgrounds of child abuse and exploitation. One girl, you might remember her story is Kaylee's story. Her mom sold her for drugs when she was 9 years old to men, and by the time she was 15, she decided that she would just start selling herself for sex. She said, I might as well sell what has been forcibly taken from me. And this is something that is going on in our community every single day. If you think it's not happening here, you need to think again. This is one of the worst crimes against humanity that there is. Human trafficking victims do not get to decide when they want a drink of water. They don't get to decide who they have sex with. They don't get to decide if they become pregnant, whether they get to keep that baby or abort that baby. Most frequently, their babies are forcibly aborted. They don't get to decide whether they'll do drugs or whether they'll stay clean, because their traffickers typically will keep them drugged up, so they will be more submissive and perform better, and the drugs also keep them coming back. It's a way of attachment and control that traffickers use. So right here in this motel, there's cockroaches that's been crawling on the walls since we walked in the door. There's a microwave that's on the floor. There's two teenagers living next door with their mom. There's a man walking up and down the sidewalk asking about heroin. There's all kinds of activity going on. This is one motel that's all this has taken place in a matter of 10 minutes of time. And in these motels, we've had a verified 16-year-old girl for sale. So this is a problem that we need to address, but the good news is that we can end this thing. We can end this thing and we can end it soon, but it takes a community to stand up and say, this will not happen on my watch. Human trafficking has definitely happened overseas, but it's happening right here in our neighborhoods. Just a few blocks from here is one of the biggest churches in Greene County. Just a few blocks from here is one of the biggest church organizations in the nation. And we have enough resources here to take care of this problem. We have enough people. But the thing is, you can't be apathetic about it anymore. In October, on October 16th and 17th, we have a Liberty Conference coming up. We have a Department of Justice agent coming down. He's going to be talking about raid and rescue and human trafficking case management programs that are effective. You're going to hear from a person who has a history of extreme violence and what it takes to overcome that. You're going to hear from a PhD addressing the demand side of sex trafficking, because the demand has to be addressed. Because as long as there is a demand, there will always be a supply. You're also going to hear from a human trafficking survivor who spent many, many years on the streets being trafficked and living in a life of horror, and how she overcome and what it takes. You're going to hear from Mark Moore from the International Justice Mission and a whole lot more. So I would just ask for you to go ahead, get your tickets now, go to libertyconference.org. and join us in ending this thing. This is not something we can turn our backs on. One more day. Thanks, guys.